Good evening, viewers. Today's topic is about mechanical injuries. Injuries are very important in forensic medicine, not only in the subject of forensic medicine. For any doctor, a medical practitioner should have basic knowledge of injuries, because whenever we come into for the law enforcing agencies, assessment of injuries and certification of injuries are important. So a doctor is supposed to know everything about injury, because the court considers that medical doctors are experts on human body. Any injury to the human body is a serious offense. So a doctor certificate of injury is valued in the court of law. It is important for the police officers in the crimes. It may be a assault or suicide or accident or murder. Anything, assessment of injury is primary. So today we are going to deal with mechanical injuries. So before that, let us know the definition of injuries. Injury, medically, it is defined very lightly. It is defined as a dissolution or disruption of the anatomical continuity of any tissue of the body. Any disruption or discontinuity, either in the surface of the body or in the deeper tissues of the body, we consider it as an injury. But law defines injury in a different way. Section 44 of IPC, Indian Penal Code, defines as any harm whatever illegally caused to any person in body, mind, reputation or property. Law considers injury in a comprehensive way, taking into account all aspects of injury. But as a doctor, we are here to describe the injury, the bodily injuries. So it is its impact on the body, its complications, it is the effect, all those outcomes, everything should a doctor has to certify. The legal definition, remember section 44 of Indian Penal Code, which defines the injury. Next slide, please. So wound. So far as wound is important, medico-legally, it includes any lesion, external or internal, caused by violence with or without a breach of continuity of skin. Violence, it should be caused by violence. It is by mechanical force or by physical force, either on the skin or in the internal organs. Next slide, please. The medico-legal definition. Mechanical injuries. Today's our primary concern is about mechanical injuries. Mechanical injuries are also called physical injuries. That means by physical objects, either by a stone or wooden log or any weapon, knife, any weapon produces a physical injury on the human body, we classify as mechanical injuries, which are caused by the physical violence to the body, depending on the manner and how they are caused. Examples are blunt force injury, sharp force injury, and a specialized injury is a firearm injury caused by pistol or rifle or whatever it is. That's the special injury. That is also mechanical injury. Everything should cause damage to the human body. Next slide, please. Madam, next slide, please. Classification of mechanical injuries. So we classify, mainly we are going to deal with this blunt force injury and sharp force injuries. Blunt force injuries are mainly three. One is an abrasion, which are in common term, we call it as scratches. Second one is contusion, also called bruising. Third one is laceration, also called as tears. So these three are the important blunt force injury, which are caused by physical trauma. Sharp force injury, which are caused by sharp weapons or objects. They are three in number: incised wounds, stab wounds, and sharp wounds. Incised wound includes our surgical incision also, or inflicted by a knife or any sharp cutting weapon. Stab wounds are also sharp force injuries where the depth is more. Sharp wounds are caused by heavy cutting weapon. Next slide, please. We'll go one by one. First, we'll deal with fractures and firearms. We'll deal with later, not in this class. So, we are going to see today about the blunt force injuries. Next slide. Abrasions. Abrasions are superficial injuries seen over the skin. It involves only the superficial layers. It is either by an impact of an object, rough surface or object, or fall on a rough surface, or pressure of fingernails, or teeth, or muzzle of a gun, or by rope. This is the commonest injury we come across in our day-to-day life. We all would have sustained this injury either by a fall. While riding a bicycle, we fall down, we sustain this injury. While skidding, we sustain this injury. Any rough surface, we rub our body over the rough surface, abrasion is caused. Or nail marks, if your nails are scratched over the surface of the skin, the abrasion is caused. Nail mark abrasions. Bite marks, if you bite lightly over the skin, the impressions are made, that is called abrasions. So these are all various circumstances. We get abraded very easily. Abrasion is the commonest injury and it is a superficial injury. There are two types of mechanism which causes. One is a tangential force where it is tangentially applied over the surface of the body. It causes friction or by the sliding movement or scraping of the superficial tissues of the body. When we fall down in a road traffic accident or while riding a bicycle, this is the commonest injury. This comes when a tangential force across the surface of the skin, either due to friction or sliding movement or the scraping of the superficial layers of the skin. Second mechanism is by compression. Compression, the mechanism is from above downwards. If the skin, surface area of the skin is compressed or pressed or pressure is applied, abrasions are caused by crushing or applying pressure over the surface of the body. So two mechanisms in abrasion. One is a tangential force, like while we are skidding when we fall down, or compressing of the skin when pressure is applied. So these are the two mechanisms by which the abrasions are caused. So we'll see the first one. In tangential force, linear abrasion is caused by tangential force. We call it as a scratch. If nail marks, we scratch over the surface of the body, it is a linear abrasion or a scratch abrasion. Then the second category, where the tangential force is applied, is during fall when we skid over the rough surface. That is called graze abrasion. Second abrasion is a graze abrasion. Commonly we come across in road traffic accident. The protruding parts of the body is affected. Front of the knee, top of the shoulder, back of the elbow, or these are the places we sustain graze abrasions. Wider part of the skin is involved. So the superficial layers are abraded, bleeds and painful graze abrasions. These are the first two mechanisms when a tangential force is applied over the skin, over the rough surface or object. If it is linear, we call it scratch abrasion. Wider part is involved as in a road traffic accident, we call it a graze abrasion. The third category is patterned abrasion. If a pattern is produced, for example, runover accidents, if the tire mark is seen over the surface of the skin, we call patterned abrasion or imprint abrasion. The fourth category is non-patterned due to contact. Example is a ligature mark in hanging. In cases of hanging and strangulation, a ligature is applied over the neck and pressure is applied. So that causes pressure abrasion. If the imprint is seen, we call it pattern or imprint abrasion. If imprint is not seen, only the abrasion is caused by the pressure, we say it is a pressure abrasion. Next slide, please. So four types of abrasion we have seen: scratch abrasion, graze abrasion, pressure abrasion, and imprint abrasion. So how do we calculate when does the abrasion is caused? Recent abrasion. First, immediately after we sustain an abrasion, it appears red. That's after 24 hours, it appears red. Then the second day to fourth day, it is reddish brown scab tissue is formed. Scab tissue is nothing but blood oozing out of the blood and serum. It dries up, forms a scab which is reddish brown in color. That is seen up to 2 to 4 days. Then the healing process starts. The scab tissue becomes very hard and it is becomes brownish. Then the epithelium grows and the dried scab falls within a week or 8 to 10 days. Then the area is pale, then the color also becomes normal within 2 weeks. So there is no infection. This injury helps us to find out when the person would have sustained this injury, abrasion. Yeah, for the first day, it is bright red in color or reddish in color. Second, third and fourth day, it is reddish brown in color because of the formation of scab tissue. Then from fourth day to seventh day, the scab becomes hard and brownish in color and it is thick. Then after a week, it falls off, the scab tissue falls off, the underlying tissue looks pale and the color also becomes normal in the second week. This abrasion heals from the periphery to the center. So the most of the time, the scab is attached to the center. So when we take bath, we try to remove. If it is hard, it will take time. If it falls off, then the color also comes back to normal. Next slide, please. So this is the example for graze abrasion on the front of the knee. Wider part of the skin is involved. This is graze abrasion. He has fallen down and graze abrasion is seen. This is commonly seen in the fall or due to traffic accident. Rubbing of the skin over a rough surface. This graze abrasions are caused. Next slide, please. Please go back, madam. One slide. Next slide, please. This is also graze abrasion. This is the elbow area, wider part of the skin is involved. You see that coloration. So we have to, any injury in forensic medicine, we have to say whether it is an antemortem injury or a postmortem injury. Antemortem injury is when a person sustains an injury during life, which is called an antemortem injury. If it has come after the death of the person, it is called postmortem injury. To clarify that, it needs expertise. So just you note down these points, you can very well say that it is an antemortem injury. It is red in color. That means it is antemortem abrasion. So antemortem abrasions are red or reddish brown, or then margins are blood due to, as I told you, it heals from the periphery to the center. So when the postmortem abrasions are caused, how to differentiate? It is yellowish in color. For example, a person is dead, his body is dragged for example, for shifting to the ambulance or for transportation. The body would have been dragged for a distance. Then it is, all these are pale yellow in color. Translucent area is seen. Margins are sharply defined. Absence of vital reaction. This is important. Any antemortem injury, red in color, bleeding may be seen, swelling may be seen. If injuries, there won't be any bleeding. There won't be any color change. There won't be any vital reaction. There won't be any infection also. Next slide. So we are dealing with abrasions. So Sometimes the artifacts, the thing which is introduced over the body after death of a person, we call it artifact. For example, during resuscitation, there we can give a DC shock, that impression may be seen. That is after death of the person. Then they to try to resuscitate, the rib is fractured, that is also an artifact. During transportation, cervical vertebra is fractured, it is an artifact. Nothing to do with injury or anything. It is in the process of treatment. Something is introduced in the body, we call artifacts. So, for example, ant bites. Ant bites human body mostly in the mucosal area, around the mouth, around the nose, around the eyes. In these areas, all over the body also, you can see ant bite marks. Or bite marks by any insects. You know, maggots, they come on legs. Maggots come, then a full-fledged worm, it goes up. So, by animal bites, bites by animals, dogs, jackal, or any animal will bite the human flesh. Some feed on the dead animals, dead flesh, by marine animals, aquatic animals, fish bites, crab bites, so many things. Any drowned body, while you are retrieving the body after a day, some places we can see the aquatic animal bites, especially over the oral cavity, nasal cavity, around the eyes, ears. These are all the soft tissues, mucosal tissues, susceptible for bite by aquatic animals. Ant bite is commonly seen, which confuses with abrasion. That is why we are brought in as artifacts. For that, you should know this is not injury. This is not antemortem abrasion. Next slide. Medico-legal aspects. So what do we understand by abrasion? As I told you, it is a superficial injury affecting only the superficial layers of the skin. So that means the site of the impact and possibility of internal injury. For example, a motor vehicle accident has taken place, road traffic accident. There is an abrasion over the front of right side of chest or upper part of the abdomen. Then that means there may be some internal injury, there may be some rib fracture, there may be some liver laceration, there may be some internal contusion, there may be some fractures. So the abrasion on the body indicates or gives us a clue that there may be some deep-seated injury. So that is the medico-legal importance of abrasion. Identification of object causing the injury. So some objects is imprinted or impregnated on the surface of the skin. That gives us a clue what could have caused the injury. For example, tire marks over the body indicates us that it is a runover accident. Then ligature mark on the neck indicates that it is a case of hanging or strangulation. Cause of injury. What has caused the injury? That can be known. For example, belt mark, tire mark, shoe imprint marks, radial grill marks, all the whip mark, all these impressions show us the object causing or the what is the cause of the injury. And the direction of injury, how will you know the direction of injury? We fall down and the body is dragged or skid over a distance, the superficial layers are accumulated in the opposite direction. For example, I scratch myself like this. The superficial layers are collected and accumulated downwardly in the opposite direction. So we can know the direction of injury. It is very useful in road traffic accident, motor vehicle accident. By the accumulation of the superficial layers in the opposite side, we know the direction of the injury. Then time of injury. How do we know the time of injury? As I told you, the color of the injury is very important in forensic medicine. Every doctor, while writing a wound certificate, you have to write a color of the injury. So if it is red, means you can very well, you will be sure that it is less than 24 hours. It is bright red, means it is less than 6 hours. So second day, third day, fourth day, it is reddish brown color. So abrasion helps us to know site of impact, identifying the object, cause of injury, direction of injury, and time of injury. These are all the medico-legal aspects of injury. See, you will know how to treat an abrasion. Because it is a superficial injury, you will dress the wound, apply some ointment, give a TT injection, nothing is required more, not even antibiotics. But as a forensic person, as your medical doctor, if you are in the casualty, you should be able to add or give more information to the investigating officer about the medico-legal importance of the injury. So you have to know what all you can observe or take home point from the abrasion. If it is a nail mark over the face or around the breast, you know it is a sexual offense case. If there is a nail mark in the throat, in the neck area, anterior and both as left and right side of neck, you see nail marks, then it can be a case of throttling. You see a ligature mark, oblique in nature, it can be a case of hanging. You see a ligature mark, horizontal ligature mark, it could be a case of throttling, strangulation, manual ligature strangulation. So if it is over the face, around the mouth and nose, it can be a case of smothering, like that. Nail marks may be seen. If it is in the neck, it is throttling. If it is around the breast and the inner aspect of thigh, it could be a case of sexual offense. So the distribution of abrasion and the appearance of abrasion gives you a clue about the seriousness of the injury. There may be a serious crime behind that injury. So outwardly you look, it is a simple injury. All abrasions are simple in nature. The dimensions may be more. It may be of any length and breadth. And remember, this is the only injury we mention in two dimensions. Only the length and the breadth is mentioned, not about the depth. So abrasions are always superficial. It involves only the superficial layers of the skin. It gives us a lot of clues about the site of impact. There may be some internal injury. It may be throttling, it may be smothering, it may be sexual offense. All these information, tire marks, we can know it is a road traffic runover accident. Object can be known. So that is about abrasion. So all these days, you would have seen abrasion only as a simple injury, easy to treat, not very much painful, healing very quickly. That only you know as a doctor. But when it comes to medico-legal application or forensic application or to the point of investigation to the police and the court, you should have a sound knowledge about what all you can infer from the abrasion. So you have to document even the small abrasion properly, which may help on a later date. A few nail marks around the nose and the mouth, no other injury over the body. It could be a case of smothering. You would have closed the mouth and nose. So a murder, that only external change is the nail marks around the nose and the mouth. So that is the importance of nail abrasion over the body. Even though it heals quickly and rapidly, superficial, it gives us a clue about the seriousness of the injury. The second blunt force injury is contusion, also called bruising. Commonly, let us mention it as contusion only for purpose. You should understand this injury properly, because difficult to understand. It is not seen outside very prominently like a abrasion or a cut injury or a stab injury or a laceration. This is below the skin. It is due to blunt force. So contusion is an infiltration or extravasation of blood into the tissue due to rupture of vessels by the application of blunt force. So this is a blunt force injury. How does it happen? By application of blunt force, what happens? The tissue is damaged, crushed. If I am hit with a wooden log, the tissues, nothing happens to the skin. Underlying the skin, there is a damage. Minute blood vessels, capillaries and venules, ruptures, minute blood vessels rupture and the blood in the blood vessel are extravasated in the surrounding soft tissues, that is contusion. The blood doesn't come out as a bleeding like in a cut injury or in a laceration. You don't see a big hematoma, you don't see profuse bleeding. Why? Because there is no rupture of the skin. The skin is intact, but there is a damage. Why does the damage happens? Because of the blunt force, application of the blunt force. Somebody punches me here, I sustain a contusion here. So somebody hits me with a wooden log or with a stone, it falls on me, and the force is sufficient, it will cause contusion underneath the skin. So how does it happen? It is because of the rupture of the minute capillaries and venules. Where the blood goes, which is coming out of the capillaries and venules, it is collected in the soft tissue, in the underlying tissues. It is called extravasation or infiltration. You cannot wash this bleeding, you cannot remove this bleeding. So this injury stays with your body until it is reabsorbed, if the person is alive, for the next 2 weeks. Otherwise, if the contusion is big, it will take a longer time. So examples are hit with a stick or a stone or a fist, contusion is caused. It's subcutaneous without discontinuity of the skin. If you remember, the body is intact, the skin is intact, only the underlying tissues are affected. Why? Because of the application of blood force. What happens? Rupture of the capillaries and venules. How the blood comes out? It is extravasated or infiltrated in the surrounding tissues. Can you remove that? You cannot remove that. Then what is the fate of the contusion? It has it has to be broken down, blood cells and other things, and reabsorbed. So this is the importance. And how we can make out? There will be some slight swelling and color change. You can make out only in fair individuals, British color people. As Indians, we are not that fair. So very difficult to make out in a dark skinned person. So remember, and usually the commonest investigation will not find out contusion. To take an X-ray, you can find out blood parameters, all things will be normal. The person will be complaining of pain. There will be mild swelling always, difficult to note. So the doctor may not appreciate the contusion. But if there is pain, the person says that he has fallen down or hit by something, you should always think of a contusion. And unlike abrasion, not only the skin is affected, all the contusion, liver contusion, kidney contusion, brain contusion, muscle contusion, anywhere contusion can take place because it is a blunt force. So the force is sufficient, the force is transmitted to the internal organs, sufficient force so that it has penetrated the deeper tissues also, contusion is seen. All organs may get contused. It is measured in 3 dimensions. The 3rd dimension only roughly. So the features of contusions, it varies in size. It may be a smaller contusion. For example, you are nailing, hitting with a hammer. By chance, you hit your finger, you sustain contusion. Why? Because of the blunt trauma. You get a contusion here. Somebody punches you over the face near the lip area. It becomes red. That is contusion. Swells, the lip swells. Boxing injuries, the black eye. It is a contusion. So it varies in size and it can form an hematoma. Superficial contusions, superficial contusions are slightly raised over the skin. I told you there may be slight swelling, but very difficult to appreciate. May not be present at the site of impact. Not necessarily it should be present at the site of impact because, because, for example, any injury over the forehead, there may be accumulation of the contusion being seen in the below the eye, because this area there is no soft tissue, so it comes to the dependent area. So we cannot say definitely that it will be seen only in the impacted area. It can be seen in the lower part because of the gravity. It settles to the lower part. If there is a contusion in the calf area, it may be settled to the ankle area. There may be a big contusion in the thigh area, it may settle in the knee area, the above knee area. So superficial contusions appear soon with red color. So immediately, like abrasion, this is also red in color. First one day, it is red in color. Deeper contusions appear late, can be detected by infrared photography. If the contusions are very deep, for example, if a cloth is tied around the arm and somebody hits with a wooden log, contusions won't be seen just below the skin. It may be seen very closer to the bone. Those are called deeper contusions. That will take time to appear to the surface. Unless it appears to the surface, we may not know that there is a contusion. So only by the color change, we know there is a contusion. So it takes time for it to appear. It is called delayed contusion. So infrared photography may reveal the deeper contusions. Contusions or bony prominences are less visible externally. Next slide. Next slide, please. What are the factors which modifies contusion? For example, these are the factors which modifies a contusion. Site of the injury. If that part which is affected is very soft, then there is more contusion. Delicacy of the tissues. If the firm tissue, it produces less contusion for particular force. Soft tissues will produce more contusion for that particular force. Vascularity of the part. The more the vascularity, the more damage it causes, the more bleeding it causes, the bigger the contusion. Age of the person. Extremes of age, children and older people, the contusion is more for the particular force, all depending on the force. Same force is applied to an adult and a child. The child will suffer more contusion. Same force is applied to an adult and an older person. Older person will have more contusion. Sex, what way it affects? Naturally, women, because of the delicacy of the tissues, they have more contusion. They cannot withstand contusion. So the size of the contusion will be bigger for the same force used against a male and a female. Female will bruise more and men will bruise less. Color of the skin. As I told you earlier, fair-skinned individual, it is easily appreciable. It is telltale. If you see that sight, you will understand it is a contusion. But darker individual, very difficult to appreciate. You should spend some time, you should have expertise, you should have seen before. So you will be able to appreciate that it is a slighter shade, darker shade will be there in dark colored people. Nature of disease. Some bleeding disorders are there, some deficiency disorders are there, some genetic disorders are there. All these, the people may bruise more, or there may be some false bruising may be seen on the surface of the skin, which is mistook as contusions, that you should be familiar with. Some bleeding disorders, you may think it is a larger contusion, whereas it is not so. Even trivial force can cause more bigger size contusion in these type of people. So you should rule out all those things before coming to your conclusion that the cause of death is this. Shifting of blood due to gravity, I told you, not in the site of impact, the contusion may be seen in the dependent area. A contusion or injury caused over the calf area, the contusion may settle down near the ankle area. Next slide. Next slide, please. Color changes in the contusion. This is the best injury to know the time since injury. That means once this injury is caused, you can very well assess later on when it could have been caused. So this is the commonest injury we come across in custodial deaths, where a person is dead inside a police station or inside a jail or during interrogation, or while taking on the way to the court or on the way to the jail, anybody dies in police custody, the commonest injury is not a cut injury or a laceration or an abrasion or a stab injury. This is the injury which comes by physical force or a trauma or torture or assault. So this is the injury we commonly come across in custodial deaths. So this has to be appreciated properly. This is the hidden injury below the skin. So the color changes are important for us to prove that it is caused during the custody period. We have to fix the time since injury to the custody period. If it is before or after, it will not come into the picture at all. We can say that these injuries are caused before the person has gone to the custody, or if it is late, it is not during the custody period. So color change of contusion is highly reliable. It will not change. So color changes in the contusion is due to disintegration and hemolysis of red blood cells. Remember, hemolysis like in jaundice. The red blood cell hemolyze and undergoes change because of that hemoglobin pigment. So those color changes are seen. Hemosiderin, iron pigments, dark brown color to blue color for 2 to 4 days. First day, it is red. Second, third and fourth day, it is bluish black or brownish black or brown in color. Then afterwards, 5 to 7 days, due to hematoidin and iron free pigment, green in color, that is 5 to 7 days. Then yellow color, 7 to 10 days. So that yellow color, we say it is jaundice. Here it comes in 7 to 10 days. So first day, red in color. Second to fourth day, it is dark brown or bluish black in color. Then fifth to seventh day, it is green in color. 7 to 10 days, it is yellow in color. Then after 2 weeks, it becomes to normal color, skin color. Pigments are removed by phagocytosis. That's normal process. Next slide, please. So the color of the contusion helps us to identify the age of the injury. This is a contusion in the upper part of the front of the thigh. Externally, this is the color change. Since she is a fair-skinned individual, we are able to notice. Otherwise, it is difficult. There will be mild swelling and it is painful. Next slide, please. This is on the right side of outer aspect of the abdomen. You can see the color change, fair individual. That's why we are able to see blunt trauma. There is a contusion, wide area is involved. Very painful condition. Next slide, please. We incise and see. Now we can do in a living person. That is done during postmortem examination. We will measure all the contusions all over the body in custodial deaths. We see black eye. His right eye is involved. Swelling is thin. Discoloration is thin. So black eye, it may be due to contusion, due to direct trauma or indirect trauma to the forehead or in the base of the skull. Next slide, please. But blunt trauma. Black eye is due to blunt trauma, boxing injury, remember. So age of the contusion, because how can you know, find out the age of the contusion? One, by the color appearance. If he is a fair skinned individual, darker individuals, you can resort to histopathological examination. Healing process depends on size and situation of contusion. Very small contusions heal on its own. Age and physique of the person, if there is a well-built adult, it will heal quickly. Presence and absence of the disease. If he is suffering from some disease, it will take some time for healing. Otherwise, it heals within 2 weeks. Next slide. Antemortem contusion. Wherever injury you see in forensic medicine, you have to say it is antemortem or postmortem. That is why we are experts. That is the most difficult part. 90% is easy. Some 10% is difficult. But always the question is asked in the court. Doctor, is it an antemortem injury or a postmortem injury? So you should be ready with your answer. Why you call it an antemortem injury? That is why we say color. Dark brown abrasion or bright red aberration or bluish black contusion, that means it is antemortem. When we see it, tell a color which is a sign of inflammation or healing, that means the person sustained the injury when he was alive. So how does an antemortem contusion look like? Sharp, well-defined margins, swelling may be seen, discoloration of the skin is seen, which is appreciated in fair-skinned individuals rather than dark-skinned individual. Extravasation of blood into the true skin and subcutaneous tissue. Due to blunt force, there is extravasation because of the rupture of the capillaries and venules. It is extravasates and permeates, infiltrates in the surrounding tissue. Doubtful cases, if you are not sure that is a contusion or not, or many very minimal contusion is there, you can ask for microscopic exam. For example, in cases of hyoid bone fracture, most of the time there is no much contusion around the fractured site, we will send the tissues for histopathology examination. But always, wherever there is a fracture, there will be surrounding contusion. That is, any fracture, even the tip of the finger, is metacarpal bones are involved, phalanges are involved, or any small little finger involved, small fracture, hairline fracture, any fracture, because it is blunt trauma, there is always a surrounding contusion. As a dictum, all injuries will have surrounding contusion. But the only thing we have to appreciate, if it is sent for histopathology, everything will have a surrounding contusion. Even abrasion, if it is forcible, there will be minimal contusion under the skin. But we may not see by our naked eye. Postmortem contusion, how it is produced? Postmortem contusions cannot be produced after death. That we can definitely say. It requires a beating heart. But sometimes a large force, for example, a big boulder stone falls on the dead body, it may produce minimal contusion. Not with respect to the size and weight of the stone and the force of the stone, it produces a little contusion. But as far as we are concerned, we say there won't be any postmortem contusion. If it is in the perimortem time and the force is extreme, then we will say minimal contusion. It does not correspond to the force of the contusion, force of the blunt trauma. Next slide, please. So do not confuse between antemortem and postmortem. Contusion, we mean it is always antemortem. Postmortem is extremely rare situation where the larger force is used to cause a minimal contusion, which we can very easily find out. Self-inflicted contusion. Rare, the person won't sustain contusion on his own, very rare. Next slide, please. They can see marking net, for example. Yeah, a seed is used to rub around the skin. It looks like contusion, not actual contusion. Homicidal contusion. Shape and size of contusion indicates the weapon use. I told you about custody death or any torture. Anybody is tortured with a blunt force, physical force, we can appreciate by the size, shape, and location of the contusion. Accidental contusion, and seen in accident, road traffic accident. Its location, its arrangements, its circumstances, surroundings tells us this is how this incident could have happened, this contusion could have been caused. We can reconstruct the crime. We can know by looking at the site of contusion, size of contusion, and appearance, locations of contusion, we can know what it is due to. That because you keep seeing injuries, you will understand better. You should know these background facts about injuries. Medico-legal aspects. In some cases, you can know the pattern of the object causing. I told you shoe marks, belt marks, whip marks, or the wooden log marks, or some metallic objects. It causes an impression over the body. So we can know the object. Degree of violence. Extensive contusion may be seen. Beaten left and right with a wooden log all over the body. You would have seen in media. A mob kills a person by blunt weapon or beating with the hands. So extensive contusion all over the body. It indicates, it tells us about the degree of violence. Third degree torture. cause of injury. What is that? How does it cost? And time of injury by the color change in the contusion. Red, first day. Second, third and fourth, bluish, black or brown. Fifth to seventh, it is greenish in color. After 7 days, up to 2 weeks, it is yellowish in color. After that, if the contusion is small, it is reabsorbed by phagocytosis. So, laceration, it is very easy. Any tear in the skin or any body tissues, maybe an intestinal laceration or a skin laceration or a muscle laceration or a liver laceration or a heart laceration or a kidney laceration, it says us that there is too much of force is used. Blunt force is used, commonly seen in traffic accidents, crush injuries, fall from height, any hit with a wooden log or with a stone, or crushed by a falling machinery, or building collapse, wall collapse. All these causes severe damage to the human body, where the tissues are torn irregularly. So these are defined as wounds caused by blunt force resulting in tearing of the skin and underlying tissue with a minimal bleeding. Since it is crushed, it will not bleed like a cut injury, little less, but still bleeding is seen. Next slide, please. Features of lacerated injury. Edges are ragged, irregular, contused. That is understood. Any tear is irregular. By laceration, we mean it is irregular. The edges are irregularly torn. That is why we suture the wound. We trim the wound and suture the wound. Why? Because it is irregular. Irregularity doesn't allow it to heal in a proper way. That is why we suture the wound. Any laceration has to be sutured. Margins are abraded due to impact of blunt force. So usually the edges are slightly abraded. Deep tissues are crushed. Naturally, the tissue is torn, then deeper tissues are crushed. Hair bulbs are crushed. So wherever there is a hair, where there is scalp area, the hair bulbs are crushed and it is attached to the injured area. Hair and less bleeding due to crushing of the underneath. It is comparative. It is not like cut injury, but still bleeding is there. But it is less when compared to a cut injury or a stab injury. Presence of foreign materials, because, for example, road traffic accident. If there is a laceration, the site where the accident has taken place, that mud and sand particles or paint or anything may be sticking to the injury. Foreign materials, sharp and irregular. Shape is very irregular. Laceration, we mean irregular. Tear is irregular. Size may or may not correspond to the weapon, because it may be torn in any direction. It depends on the toughness of the tissue and the force applied. It may tear in any direction. Yielding surfaces, it tears very extensively. So margins are irregular. The floor of the laceration shows tacks of tissues in the bottom. Damage to the tissue is gross and extensive because it is crushed. Hemorrhage less compared to cut injury. Foreign material like mud, sand, all may be attached. Gravels may be seen in injured area, in the lacerated area. Healing process delayed because of the damage of the tissues. We call debridement. The damaged and the tissues are, some tissues have to be trimmed down for correcting the injury, for approximating the injury, to suture the injuries properly. So that those tissues damage is always there. Scars due to damage to skin and tissue. Scar tissue is formed. Any injury below the skin forms a scar. When the full thickness skin damage causes a scar, except abrasion, laceration, cut, incised wound, stab wound, all causes scar. Only abrasion, which is because it is simple, it doesn't cause a permanent scar. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. There are many types. I'm not going to go into detail. I want to summarize these three injuries. Madam, focus the PowerPoint. This blur. Okay. types of lacerated wounds, split laceration. It splits wherever there is an underlying bone, it splits. You can see in boxing injuries. In this area, there it looks like a cut injury, but it is not a cut injury because the bone is nearby, it splits. It looks like a cut injury. Found in area, spots and overlying bones, scalp, face, hands and lower lip. Wherever there is a bone very close to the skin, it splits like a cut injury. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. Then it is a stretch. When the skin is stretched beyond a limit, beyond its elasticity level, it tears. That is called stretch laceration. For example, if your fingers are caught in the door handle, we pull it, it causes a stretch laceration due to overstretching of the skin and produces a flap. Due to blunt tangential impact when head strikes on the windscreen of the vehicle. Due to sudden deformity of bones after fractures. After fracture, the long bones are fractured. Then the skin is stretched, it will lacerate. That is called stretch laceration. Next slide, please. Avulsion, degloving of skin over the impacted area due to compression and grinding of overlying tissue. For example, heavy runover accident, the complete muscle mass will come from its attachments, commonly seen in road traffic accident and by machinery in heavy industries. If a heavy wave machinery falls over the body, the entire muscle mass may be removed along with the skin. That is a avulsion. Tear laceration, due to friction with irregular or pointed end of a weapon or an object on the surface of the body, deeper at the starting point than at the, it is due to friction with irregular or pointed object. If some pointed object is seen here, we pull it off, then it tears. Cut laceration, this is by a, not a sharp weapon, but it's a laceration with a heavy blunt object. It can cut the tissue, but it is not sharp enough. So both sides will have laceration and also underlying contusion. So this type of lacerated wound is produced by not so sharp weapon. Go back, madam. Previous slide, please. Seen in sharp wounds, the weapon may not be sharp, margins are not clear cut, abrasions and contusions are seen under margin. If contusion is seen, weapon is not sharp, we say it is cut laceration. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. These are all examples for laceration, irregular. It looks like a cut injury, but it is a irregular injury. Some areas, you see the borders, it will be irregular. Next slide, please. This is by some objects, which is not very sharp. The margins are irregular. Some areas, if you see closer only, you will find out. If you see at a distance, it's like a incised wound. It is not an incised, it is a curved. Some areas you see contusion, some areas irregular, some skin tags are attached. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. Lower lid. See the lower lid. This is liver laceration. Blunt trauma to the anterior fossa part of right side of abdomen. Next slide, please. Internal organs also get lacerated because of the severity of the force which strikes the surface. This is mostly homicidal, occurs in any part of the body. Any part may be lacerated. Produced by blows with the hand and or blunt weapon or any object. Suicidal, it is very rare. Accidental, commonly seen in road traffic accidents or fall from height or foreign bodies, mud or gravel may be attached here. Next slide, please. I'll stop with the laceration. Madam, close the PowerPoint. I'll brief and close the class. Today we were discussing about mechanical injuries. Mechanical injuries we classify into three types: blunt force injury, sharp force injury, and fractures and dislocations. And specialized injuries are firearm injuries. I'm not going to go into detail about sharp force injury, fractures, and firearm injuries. Today our topic is mainly about blunt force injury. There are three we have seen today. One is an abrasion, which are in common terminology we call it scratches. There are four types of abrasion. The first one is a scratch abrasion. Examples are nail marks and bite marks. The second one is a graze abrasion, commonly seen in road traffic accidents, over the exposed parts of the body, back of the elbow, front of the knee, back of the top of the shoulder. These are all the places we commonly sustain abrasions. Wider areas are involved. When you fall down, we sustain this injury. This is due to tangential force, as rubbing force over the surface of the skin. Scratch and graze are due to tangential force. The third one is a pressure abrasion. It is the force acting from above downwards over the surface of the skin. That is due to pressure. Examples are ligature mark in hanging, ligature mark in strangulation. Because of the application of pressure over the skin for a considerable time and a force is applied, that is why these pressure abrasions are seen over the neck in hanging and strangulation. The fourth category is the imprint abrasion, which tells us that what is the object which causes the abrasion. This is also a type of pressure abrasion, but additional information is we know what object it has caused. For example, tire marks in road traffic accident. So four types of abrasion: scratch abrasion, graze abrasion due to tangential force, pressure abrasion, and imprint abrasion due to pressure from the forces from above downwards. So these are the four types of abrasion. What do you know about this abrasion? Because abrasions are superficial injury affecting only the skin. It is always a simple injury. It heals very quickly, within 1 week to 2 weeks. It does not leave a scar. That is why we call it a simple injury. It will produce less like bleeding and pain, but it will heal automatically. It will not leave a scar throughout our life. Permanent scar is not there. So this is the about the characteristics of the abrasion. What is the medico-legal point we can know is, this shows us the site of impact. Where you see abrasion in the site, you fall down, you sustain injury, abrasion over the front of knee, because that is the site of impact. You are landed on your knee, or your knee is dragged on the rough surface. So site of impact is known. Another example is nail marks in over the front of sides of the neck in cases of throttling. Nail marks over the nose and mouth in cases of smothering. So outside we see only nail marks, but inside it is a serious crime. One is a smothering, another is a throttling, both are murders. So abrasion gives us a clue that it could be a serious offense. Nail marks over the breast area in respect of thigh, it could be a case of sexual offense. Bite marks or nail marks over the breast area and the genital area or the thigh area, we suspect sexual offense. So this is the additional information. Then it may indicate a deep-seated injury. For example, there may be underlying fracture or underlying contusion or underlying serious injury. Abdominal area, so superficially there is an abrasion on the right side of the abdomen, upper part of abdomen. There may be a liver injury. So it gives us a clue about the deep-seated injury. Then color of the injury. If it is bright red, we say it is 1 day old. If it is reddish brown, we say 2 to 4 days old. If it is dark brown in color, 5 to 7 days old. then if the then the scab, all these are due to the scab formation. The scab falls off, then that area looks pale. Then the normal color also is achieved or regains its normal skin, regains its normal color in 2 weeks. So by the color of the abrasion, we know when it is caused. Time since injury can be known by the doctor. He can give a clue to the investigating officer. So this is the medico-legal importance of knowing the color. How we should write an abrasion? We should first write the location of abrasion, then the dimensions of abrasion, where the location is seen: back of the elbow, front of the knee, or top of the shoulder. Look, yeah, that is important because it says that it could be due to fall or it could be due to accident. Then about the size of the injury, this is the only injury we write in two dimensions: length and the breadth. Whatever may be the dimension, it may be 22 centimeter into 13 centimeter, still it is a simple injury because heals quickly and rapidly and without leaving a permanent scar. So dimensions, then color of the injury. Always write the color so that we will know the time since injury. This is how we should describe the injury. Every abrasion should be noted down in the wound certificate. Today we have seen about mechanical injury. Only we have seen about the blunt force injury. Why this is important? This is the commonest injury we see. Abrasions are the most common injury. Second is contusion. Third is laceration. Cut injury, stab injury, fractures are comparatively rarer than this blunt force injuries. So I have summarized then about the abrasion. Then about the contusion. Contusion is blunt force injury. Application of blunt force over the surface of the body. The skin is intact, but the underlying tissues are damaged. How is this damaged? Because of the force, the capillaries and venules rupture, and there is extravasation or infiltration of blood in the surrounding soft tissue, leading to this bleeding cannot be removed or washed away. It is not a bleeding outside. It is not a hematoma big sized. It is minute, microscopic vessels are damaged, leading to extravasation. This is a good injury. You should remember because it is not known by our routine investigation. There may be slight swelling and it may be painful. So you have to anticipate. The patient complains of pain, extreme pain in the area affected, suspect contusion. Commonest injury in custodial deaths, in police torture or any torture for that matter. Contusion is a unseen injury, can be appreciated in fair skinned individual. Dark skinned individual, it is a little bit difficult, but in a living person, it is, you cannot probe the injury. But when we do postmortem examination, we will incise and see every part of the body looking for contusions. Because in custodial deaths, National Human Rights Commission asks us whether we have ruled out torture, any blunt trauma, any lathi beatings, or any custodial torture. So every part of the body, we have to make linear incisions all over. Deeper incisions are made to rule out any minute contusion. It is difficult for the medical officers to assess, but you should have a sound knowledge about contusion. It is caused by blunt force due to rupture of minute blood vessels. It heals in 2 weeks. If it is extensive, it can cause death also. Contusion can be seen in the internal organs also. If the force is more, the size of contusion is more. There are multiple contusions of larger size. The person may die of contusion only. If the blood loss is more than 1/3 of the blood circulating blood volume. If there is internal contusion, for example, in the heart, in the lungs, in the liver, in the spleen or kidneys, the person may die of the functional disability of the organ. If the heart contusion is there, if the heart doesn't work along with the other parts of the body, affected area, contused area of the heart, heart will go for failure. Likewise, liver, there is a contusion, the liver may fail. There is a kidney contusion, the kidney may fail. Likewise, any brain contusions may be seen. That part of the brain will not work. If it is more, a person may die. If the functional ability is compromised because of the contusion, persons may die of smaller contusions of vital organs. Remember this. only the surface condition we are talking about. There may be internal conditions of the vital organs which is life threatening. These small contusions can kill a person. Surface contusion, it will be painful, but it will heal if it is the area involved is less. That is laceration. I told you about laceration. Laceration is a tear in the tissues. Skin may be torn, any internal organ may be torn, intestines may be torn. It indicates the force used, crushing force. There may be underlying contusion or irregular tear. It is a commonest injury you come across in clinical practice. We road traffic accidents, we suture the wound to approximate the wound, we debride the areas which is affected, then approximate the wound and make a suture so that it will heal in 2 weeks. So it is a laceration, is a tear that you will know, you have come across many times. It is an irregular tear. Internal organs are torn, difficult to correct, corrected only by surgeries, meticulous and specialist surgeries are done. Liver laceration, for example, is if it is a size is small, they can do surgery and correct. If it is big, very difficult to control the bleeding. Within few minutes, the liters of blood will be wasted and accumulated in the peritoneal cavity. So likewise, anywhere there is a laceration, it crushing of the tissues are seen, damage is more, healing also takes lot of time. So these are the three injuries: abrasion, contusion and laceration. Abrasion and laceration you can appreciate because by looking itself you will see and tell what is the extent, where it is seen, what is the dimension, what is the color. It is all understood by you. But I would stress you to understand contusion better, also called bruising. It is a blunt trauma. Skin is intact, but underlying tissues are damaged. You should have background knowledge to assess contusion, commonly seen in torture, in custodial death. Color helps us, that too in fair individuals, not in dark-skinned people. It is painful and mild swelling may be seen. You should see to it that you appreciate contusion if there is a blunt trauma involved, also seen in accidents. Any questions, kindly type and send it to me. I'll be here to answer your queries. I think I'm exceeding my time. So blunt force injuries in mechanical injuries. Thank you all. Thank you very much.